విశాఖలో ఈ గవర్నెన్స్ పై జాతీయ సదస్సు జరుగుతోంది. ఇప్పుడు సదస్సును లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
Of a war on corruption and war on black money. The idea is to see that the entire money that is and the entire wealth is put to proper use and account the money. Accounting the money, the best way is the demonetization, remonetization. Some friends are asking, what happened to us? What is the benefit we get? What is it? Everything has come to bank. That's what we want, na? Everything has to come to bank. Everything is coming to bank. We are the happiest people today because earlier it was not coming to bank. It was circulating among themselves. Today it has come back to banks. You call it as 15 lakh crores or 14 lakh crores, whatever it is, or 16 lakh crores. The entire amount has come back to bank. That means the notes have come to open. They were hiding. They were hiding. Some of the notes were sleeping. Others were weeping. Now the notes have come to open. That is the biggest advantage you have. That is the biggest advantage you have. Why others are weeping? You have money, more money, fresher money, corrupt money, easy money, loose money. You spend it lavishly in whatever manner you want. Others are honest and tax paying. They are suffering poor people. They cannot compare with this, compete with this unhealthy wealthy. And then the hard working people who are paying taxes regularly. There was a heart burning among those people. So this inequality has to put an end at the earliest. That is the intention of the Prime Minister. And then the Prime Minister want to see that the money comes back to the system and money is pumped in again to development. You will be seeing in the coming days, budget is there, after budget also in the coming 2 years, you will see that the growth story of India will be further accelerated. And even already today and the entire world is slowing down, even China is slowing down. India is the only bright spot where the growth rate is more than 7%. This is not what Venkaiah Naidu is saying, World Bank is saying it, World Economic Forum is saying it, Asian Development Bank is saying it, and Moody rating also is saying it, and S&P also is saying it. Everybody is saying India is the bright spot, they are ready to invest. But once you create this wealth, health has to be distributed. And if you have to distribute the wealth, you need to know where the wealth is. And this IT brings you the transparency in the system. You can know what is happening, where it is, if you go for digital. And then secondly, it will bring you accountability. Who is accountable? Who is failing? Where the fault lies? This also can be known through if you use proper IT. So transparency and accountability. And responsiveness also. If you make all the services available to the people and if you give permissions online, nobody need to stand in line. If you make services online, nobody need to stand in a line. Otherwise, whoever made them to stand in line, they will be in the firing line. Keeping that in mind, we have to use this proper application of this technology that is available to us. I will just give few examples which have been given by the Honorable Prime Minister about what is happening to our system and to taxation and all. If you go through the details, you will be stunned. 3.7 crore assessing the total population of over 130 crores of people. Our population has surpassed 125. We are still mentioning 125 only. It is 133 crores. By the time I complete my speech, it may increase further also. 133 crores population. And how many people are paying, how many people are coming to the tax net? The total assessees in India are 3.7 crores. And out of 3.7 crores, 99 lakh people declare income below 2.5 lakhs. That is allowed, income tax exemption. People are hoping for further enhancement of this exemption. Let us be positive about it. I can't say anything because budget is coming. 2.5 lakh, that means 99 lakh people have gone. From 3.7 minus 99, and then 1.95 crore people declare income less than 5 lakhs. 52 lakh people declare income between 5 to 10 lakhs, and only 24 lakh people declare income above 10 lakhs. In this country, people who are paying income tax 10 lakhs and above are only 24 lakh people. And how many big bench cars? This car and that car, I need not describe the cars. How many cars are there in this country? You count in Vishakhapatnam itself. how many high-rise buildings are there. That means we are trying to face the system. So we have to find out now where this money has gone, where it is lying. So one is currency, the second is of course the assets also. That also is not going to be left free. There will be needed action also will be taken on that count also with regard to Binami properties also. So keeping this in mind, now we have to really make best use of this IT and find out and reach out to people who are not reaching the system. So if everybody comes into the tax net, the tax rate will come down. If everybody comes into tax system, the interest rates also will come down. Now banks are flushed with money. Already banks have reduced the rates, you have seen also. Banks' interest rates are reducing, and poor and vulnerable sections like the middle class, lower income group and also poorer sections, you have 6.5% interest subvention. You have 4% interest subvention for the middle class and lower middle class, and middle class you have interest subvention of 3%. The interest rate on housing has come down. Once the interest rates come down, there will be housing boon. And then people will be, more and more people will be able to afford to houses also. So and secondly, friends, if the services that are offered by the government, if they reach people without any filtration, without any leakage, that is the best thing we can do. Late Rajiv Gandhi said, if I send 100 rupees from Delhi, put it in a pipeline, by that time it reaches Thiruvananthapuram and Ananthapuram, only 85 rupees are leaked and 15 rupees are reaching. This is what he has lamented, rightly so. He was sincere that way, on that count. But what has happened? Nothing could happen. Now the Prime Minister is very keen to see that everything comes to the system, and that's why he has asked everyone to open the bank account. Bank account open karne se kya hoga, kya fayda hoga, aisa sawal puchna again. Now people have understood what is the advantage of having a bank account and what is the advantage of our neighbor also having a bank account. Even servant also having a bank account. That also has been realized by many people. But that is not going to help them, that they will realize it little later. We can come to it later also. Friends, then the question is of some people are saying this thing has happened suddenly. No, opening the bank account, secondly, constituting a special investigation team in the very first cabinet meeting to unearth black money. Third is raising the issue in G20 nations. Fourth is having agreement with Switzerland. Fifth is having agreement with Cyprus. Sixth is having agreement with Mauritius. Seventh is having agreement with Singapore also. And then having agreement with America to exchange information with regard to tax, investments, evasions, etc. And then giving one-time opportunity of income declaration, and then also forewarning the people. Then Binami Transactions Act, which was passed in 1988 root, late Rajiv Gandhi period. It is kept in cold storage. Nothing happened all these years. And this government have notified that also. Series of steps, one after another, the government have been taking steps to see that the black money is unearthed, everything is brought into system, and everything is transparent, so that ultimate beneficiary will be the poor, and ultimate beneficiary will be the middle class. This is how the Prime Minister is moving. Friends, the Prime Minister want to change the country. He want to modify the country. There is a big campaign going on in the country, campaign Modi. Modi means not Narendra Modi, M-O-D-I, Making of Developed India. That is a campaign of M-O-D-I, Modi campaign. We should all join that campaign, every state and centre. That's why Prime Minister also has given a call for Team India. Mere Chandrababu Naidu doing it in Andhra Pradesh alone will not suffice. The entire country should do it. He has taken the lead. Even now also, even the demonetization period also, in Andhra Pradesh, because of the steps he has taken with regard to fair price shop, with regard to other facilities, comparatively the pain was less. Comparatively. There was pain. Nobody, no doubt about it. I am not ignoring. I am not trying to make light of the pains and all across the country. There is pain, no, undoubtedly. When you are going for a big transformation, when you are going for a revolution, when you are going for a major surgery, there will be some pain. That's why I said if you are bitter pill for long-term ill, temporary pain for long-term gain. That is the lesson we have to understand, because the country has suffered all these years. Suffered all these years, and also the grey assets. My salutation to the ordinary people of India, ordinary, understand, underline, ordinary people of the India. They have stood in lines, they have queued up in lines for their future. They were patient to bear the pain for their future. and they were also having confidence about the capacity, caliber and conduct of the Prime Minister because of the commitment of the Prime Minister and the work he is doing and the honesty and integrity. People have borne the pains and disappointed our other friends, opposition friends. Our opposition friends are disappointed. Hey, people are patient, no writing, no writing, no writing in the country. For 2 months, no writing. They are all worried. And you have seen even from the judiciary also, that word came, there may be rights. They may be also disappointed, those people who have made that comment. They also might have got disappointed, there were no rights also. The reason is, people want a change. They are tired of the system. They want that the wealth to be distributed in proportion. They want these economic disparities to be reduced. They want corruption to be eliminated. They want speedy disposal of their problems. And they want the implementation of the promises given by the government. So that's why they are having confidence and they have shown this monumental patience. I can call it as a monumental patience. That's why hats off to Indian people, that to ordinary people, for the patience they have shown in this suffering. Friends, today, as I was telling you, the entire system has been now, this thing. Prime Minister has given a call for Team India, number one. Second, he has given a program of MICDC, MI, Make in India, SI, Skill India, DI, Digital India, CI, Clean India. So Team India, Make in India, Skill India, Digital India, Clean India, all will make strong India. So we have to really see that all these programs of the Prime Minister, they are not mere slogans. He is trying to improve the system, he is trying to improve the delivery system, and where this information technology and there this digital transfer can play an important role to the life of the ordinary people, that will really help us. The Prime Minister ultimately wants to see that the benefits reach people directly without leakage. The package without leakage should reach the people. That's the aim of the Prime Minister. And you have seen also how things are happening. And the call given by the Prime Minister, see the response of the people of India, he has given a call for the people, by whoever is affluent, please return the subsidy for LPG. 1 crore 25 lakh people have voluntarily returned their LPG subsidy. That is the greatness of the people. Because the leader is inspiring. The leader is inspiring. Because people are confident that the overhead tank is clean, they will not get any more polluted water. That's why they have the confidence in the overhead tank. They have the confidence of the leader. Secondly, he wants to see that the money which is given to the people by Chandrababu Naidu or by Narendra Modi or by KCR, by anybody, it should reach the people. It should reach the people that for that DBT, direct benefit transfer. Direct benefit transfer. Your scholarship, your pension, your subsidy, your compensation, whatever you are going to give, it should reach the people without any leakage. For that he came out in this JAM, Janadhana Yojana, then Aadhaar and then Mobile. J-A-M, you can get your money directly. So now slowly we are moving towards getting money, whatever money is put there, it will be known in your mobile. And you can, coming days, you can draw your money also through mobile. Some people, the other day Chandrababu Naidu was asking some people, how many people are not having telephone, raise cell phone. Some people are hesitating because they know that Chandrababu Naidu will not leave it like that. If they say they don't have, then he will give telephone also. That much assurance they have. That's why they are hesitating to raise their hands. In the coming days, there is no need even to have mobile also. You can directly transfer money if you have thumb. Whatever unte, prati okkaru kuda phone avasaram lekundane dabbulanu evariki kavalante vallu chelinchovachani. Whatever aithe andariki untundi kada, I think everybody is having a thumb. Everybody may not go for thumb impression, but everybody has got a thumb. So this is the great transformation that has come in the technology. This is the great transformation that is coming in the administration. So we must come out with much more innovative steps to see that people are given better services, people are given correct information, people are assured and of a responsive governance at every level. In that, this e-governance plays an important role. This is the last point I want to tell. The e-governance will provide you proper governance and will make you to know what are your rights, what are your responsibilities, what are your duties, what are your entitlement. through e-governance, you can know your entitlements, and then you can ask for your entitlements, and you can apply online, and you will get reply also online, and there will be supply also.
విశాఖలో జరుగుతున్న ఈ గవర్నెన్స్ సదస్సులో కేంద్ర మంత్రి వెంకయ్య నాయుడు మాట్లాడారు.